Hi everyone, I'm George, this is Jurijs. We're in Jurijs' flat. Behind me is an ADA60P with the Epic ADA Solar RGB. And we're going to just talk about a little technique that Jurijs is experimenting with to grow a Monte Carlo carpet. So I'm just going to switch the camera around so we can get a better view.
And this is the lazy dry start method.
Just go through what dry start method is for people that might not know.
Yeah, for those of you who don't know, what is a dry start method is where you scape a tank, you put in the substrate, you put in the hardscape, and most people use the DSM with a carpet. So you just plant the carpet, you spray it very well, you put a clear film on top, you keep it like this for a period of 4 or 6 weeks, you give it a daily spray, you open it so they get some fresh air inside, and what happens? It's like in the nursery. It's very high humidity, the plants grow in, no water changes, no algae, you have a full carpet. You fill the tank and the tank looks good immediately from day one. But then you have again to make it cycle because the biology is not yet there and the filter is not running, etc., etc. So this is taking the whole DSM concept to the next level. So this is for the very lazy people like myself or very busy people.
Yeah, I say busy, not lazy.
Yeah, it's
yeah.
Yeah, busy.
Because we're professionals.
And as you can see here, it doesn't look like planted. It more or less look like it has been sprinkled. And that's what I did exactly. Credit goes out. Shout out to our Canadian friend, brother in crime, Art Commissio, aka Aquascape Goat. And yeah, basically what you do, you kind of cut the Monte Carlo into small trimmings and you sprinkle them over the soil. Yeah, let's open the tank. Give it some.
Oh, I love that smell. That soil, is that ADA? I say Tropica soil.
Yeah, that's Tropica soil, yes. Yeah, since I'm working for them.
So basically, all you've done, Jurijs, is just chopped up a load of Micranthemum Monte Carlo stems and sprinkled them on top.
I did it, you know the salt bay?
Yeah, yeah.
The guy?
They sprinkled. Yeah, so, show the guys what you mean.
Yeah, the salt bay where you have a nice, juicy steak, and then you take the salt, you make like this. Yeah, the salt going to the meat. That's what I did here with the Monte Carlo. That's why I call it the LDSMB, the lazy dry start method bay. Yeah, whatever. Monte Carlo is in there. I give it 2 times a day a good spray. Here and there in between, I have a dwarf hair grass planted, the Iwagumi mini. And I did a third thing on this tank, and this is the moss graffiti. If you have a close look on the rocks over there, you see some mud almost everywhere on the rocks. So what I did, I took some Ricardia moss, Ricardia chamaedrifolia, and I blended it with water and a little bit of soil. The soil is there to give some sort of stickiness to the whole mixture, mm-hmm. and also it will provide nutrients to the growing moss because the spraying water is very poor in nutrients. So with having some soil dust in the mix, in the mud, there are some nutrients there like in nature. So we have like particles of moss all over the rocks. If you look very close right now, it's still difficult to see, but you know,
with
our eyes we can see it. You can zoom in. I don't know, I already see some little green dots here and there. They're mainly not yet fresh growth. I would say they're particles from the, yeah, from the original moss. And it's been just, I don't know, 3 days or something. Yeah, you can zoom in. So this is maybe a little particles of moss.
That green bit right in the center of the screen.
I don't know if it's already growing. Yeah. We can only speculate. It can be from the leftovers from the original moss. But really nice is you can already see the growth of the Monte Carlo, like over here. I don't know, George, if you can have a close look over there. There is a stem of Monte Carlo laying there.
That's new growth, that is.
Yeah, go over there. Where's my finger? There, there. If you zoom in.
This bit here.
So there is one tiny root going down from the stem, and that's happening like here and there, everywhere. Some of the roots are sticking into the air. Within a few weeks, I expect the Monte Carlo to root itself and then uptake nutrients and then speed up in the growth process. So what's happening inside here? 2 times a day, I give it a good spray. 1 in the morning, 1 in the evening, the lights are on for 12 hours. Because it's dry start, no algae, you know, and yeah. That's basically it.
Thanks, Jurijs.
You're welcome.
Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed that little video all about how to potentially really cheat with growing a carpet of Micranthemum and Monte Carlo. I guess if this method works, you could potentially use it for other carpeting species, but I think Monte Carlo is one of the easier ones to kind of try.
I think Monte Carlo is one of the easiest ones, and this is an experiment. I know Art did it before, once, so this is the second time we are trying to kind of apply this technique. If that's working, you're welcome to copy it, and please give credit to Art.
Yeah.
And yeah, if it works, it's amazing. It's more easy for everyone. Yeah. I mean, dry start is easy, and this is even easier, and we will try in future with other plants as well.
It's all about trying to make the hobby easier for people, isn't it? Making it more accessible. It doesn't have to be hard. Okay guys, that wraps it up for today's video. I hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks to Jurijs for inviting me into his beautiful home again and letting me see his beautiful aquariums. Leave a comment. Have you ever heard of dry start? Have you tried dry start before yourselves? Let me know your experiences. Subscribe if you haven't, give us a thumbs up if you like the video, and keep on scaping. Take care guys. Cheerio.